So what I'm going to show you now is how to spot a TLC plate or a TLC chromatography paper. Now what I've got here are samples, and these samples are in these micro test tubes here. Now you might be supplied samples actually in the micro test tubes, or you might be given micro test tubes which you'll have to label, and then you'll have to drop the ion samples into those first before you do anything. So that's going to depend on where you are. As you can see, they're all labeled on top, and that's very important. Now there's two kinds of micro test tubes that you're likely to experience. The first kind is just the kind where you have the simple flip top, and the idea is that you just flick that open and that opens it up. That's fairly simple. There is another kind though, and that's this kind here. And what I want you to see, it has this little ball assemblage in a notch. And the way you open those is to flick the ball down and then to flip the top open. I'm going to try and show you how to do that. It might be a little hard to see with my thumb in the way, but what I did just now was I just flicked that ball down. You can see it's no longer in the notch. Just flick that down here and then the whole thing can be opened up. Now to close it again, just reverse the process, just flick the ball back up. Now what I'm going to show you is how we actually spot the plate or TLC paper. And what we're going to be using here is what's called a capillary. Now a capillary is a long thin tube, it's open at both ends. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this capillary into one of the samples. I'm going to choose the AG Plus sample since that's the one that I want first. So let me open that up here, just as I did before. And there it is. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the capillary into the sample, and the sample is going to run up the capillary just by capillary action. Now keep in mind, I don't have to do anything else with this capillary, like put my finger on top or anything else. I just leave it the way it is, and the liquid will run up all on its own. So here's what's going to happen. All right, so you just dip it in, and you can see the sample has run up the tube all by itself. Now this particular capillary tube is one of the larger variety, and I recommend if it's a large capillary tube to go ahead and just empty a little bit out onto a paper towel, and that's what I'm going to do over here. And that just means just tapping it on the paper towel. Now there's still sample in there, of course, but it gets any big drops off the bottom that might cause a large diameter spot when I put it on the plate. So I go over here and I'm going to put this onto the AG Plus area that I've marked on this TLC paper. Now what I've done is I've got a centimeter line from the bottom, a centimeter from the top, and these are about a centimeter apart right here. I want to try and keep the diameter of my spot fairly small, and what that means is I want to do a fairly light tap onto the TLC paper. So watch carefully as I do this. I'll try and keep it so my hand's out of the way. And I will just gently tap the AG Plus portion here, trying to leave just a very small diameter spot. Hold the capillary fairly vertical and then just drop it gently onto the paper, and don't leave it there too long. Just a gentle tap is all it should need. There we go. That's about the size spot that you want to have. You don't want any bigger than that. And you'll notice all I did to get that was just to tap it. If you leave it on the paper, it is going to give you a much, much larger spot. So just a gentle tap and a small diameter spot, if you could possibly do it. Right, I'm going to do this, wait for this to evaporate a little bit more. And that's a good idea if you want to make sure that you get a good concentration of ions in the spot, is to spot it again, but you need to wait for the solvent to evaporate a bit before you try and add a little bit more. Of course, you don't have to refill it. It's still got sample in the capillary, as you can see. So waiting for it to evaporate a bit more, and then just a very light tap again. There we go. That's about the size you want. You do not want any bigger than that on the size of the spot. If you have it too big, you're going to end up getting some tailing, which means that the spot will go here and you'll end up getting some tailing at the end of it. So we're just going to try and avoid that, and hopefully we'll end up getting good samples at the end of this. So I'm going to show you what we need to do in between samples now. And over here I've got this set up. Let me zoom out a bit here. And what I've got is a bit of paper towel and a beaker with some DI water in it. The first thing I'm going to do is empty my capillary. And I do that just by touching it onto the paper towel, as you're seeing me do it here. And it forms obviously a big spot there, and as you can see, there's nothing left in the capillary. So I'm going to fill that now with water. And again, just dip it in, pull it out, and just touch and tap the water onto the paper towel, thus emptying it and cleaning the capillary. We don't want to get a new capillary each time, that'd be a waste. We can just clean it in between uses. If you do this twice, you should be good. So I just empty it out, and then I can go ahead and spot my next sample. So I'm going to spot all the samples on here, and then we will develop it. Alright, so what I've done is I've spotted these. I've got the Ag+, the CO2+, the Cu2+, the Fe3+, the Bi3+, and I've also spotted an unknown as well. The unknown could be a combination of 2 to 4 of any of those ions that we have listed there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and develop it. And for that I'm going to use the developing chamber. I'm going to bring the developing chamber over here. Presently, there's nothing in it. And this is eluting solution. That's what I'm going to add to the developing chamber, eluting solution. And you'll see what this eluting solution will do in a second. I'm going to add this in here. It's really important that the level of this solution stays below this line right here, where the ions are all placed. Otherwise, what will happen is the eluting solution will wash the ions off and you won't get a good result. Now, one thing you can do, it's kind of optional really for this, because this could probably fit in the eluting container, in the developing container, and it probably wouldn't really need tape. But optionally, what you can do, you can take some tape here and you can make this into a little cylinder. And I'm a little bit thumby here because I've got the gloves on. But there we go. Something like this is fine. So it's just a very rough cylinder, essentially. And then we can stick that into the developing chamber. And it's really important that once you've put it into the developing chamber, that you don't move it and you don't move the developing chamber. Now, as you can see, the level of the liquid in there is below the level of the line where the spots were placed. And what's going to happen is, over the course of the next 30, 45 minutes, an hour, what's going to happen is that the eluting solution will move its way up the plate. And hopefully you can see that there is movement of this solvent line up the plate. I know it's a little bit hard to see here, but it is happening. Now what's going to happen is ideally we want to leave this in here long enough so that it reaches that top line, the line at the top of the paper. So I'm not sure that we'll be able to leave it in there that long, but we want to leave it in for as long as we can to let this go as high as it possibly can, and we get the best separation of our ions and the best RF for our spots that we will calculate later on. All right, I'm going to leave it there for now, and we'll come back to this once it's come up the plate a bit further. So we've been sitting here waiting for the solvent to come up the plate here, or the paper, and it's almost the line, so I'm going to go ahead now and pull this out. Slowly, carefully, untape it, and then I can lay this out on a couple of bits of paper towel, just like this. You'll notice there are some colors here. Once I've dried this, I'm going to, well, you should definitely note what colors you see prior to staining and then after staining. All right, so I'll stop here for a second. I'll go get a hairdryer. All right, so we've taken our plate out of the developing chamber, our paper. And Justin, would you please zoom in on that? And you should be able to see some colors there. I'm hoping you might see some colors on those spots. They might become a little bit clearer after I dry it. You ready? Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start drying this. I'll put it on a low setting first. Just a low setting is pretty much all you really need here, just to dry off the solvent. Okay, that should be pretty much it. Should be good enough. And hopefully you can see some colors there. You definitely want to note any colors that you see prior to staining. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to stain the TLC paper or the plate, and I've got this staining reagent right here, and I'm going to just go ahead and spray the plate with it, and it will make some of these things turn different colors. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and dry this. So I'm going to dry this off here. Just on low. So I'll do this for a couple of minutes. That'll probably do it. And as you can see, some of the things turn different colors from what they were. And it's going to be important for you then to write down those colors after staining as well. So there were colors before on some of them, and then there were colors afterwards on some of them. And this will help you to identify your unknown as well. So as you can see from this one, if I had to guess what was in the unknown, I'd say this one here, which I guess is the, well, I guess it's the copper 2+. Then you've got the iron here, and I can see both of those in the unknown. That's what I would reckon is probably in the unknown after I go ahead and stain this. All right, so that's it for that.